Hello and welcome to the channel. Today we are here at Helen Lake. We are right off of Thousand Island Lake Road, which is also known as Gogebic 535. And we are Sylvania Wilderness adjacent. So this lake is not in Sylvania. However, there is a portage that you can take to get over to Clark Lake and get into the wilderness, and we'll show you that today. But it's just outside. Let me go ahead and get the canoe off the car and we'll get onto the water. Okay, so we're off. So, Helen Lake. I don't want you to get confused because earlier this year I did another video up Helen Creek to Helen Lake, and that is a different Helen Lake. That one is actually not too far from here, but it's in Wisconsin. It flows out of the Cisco chain, and this is Thousand Island Lake Road here next to us, and Thousand Island Lake is on the Cisco chain. Today we're going to, I think, go around counterclockwise around the whole lake and just basically explore. I don't have the stats for this lake off the top of my head, but I will grab those, put them on screen along with a Michigan DNR lake map so you can see the depth and the shape of the lake. Hoping to see some loons today, you never know. I would think the adults are probably pretty close to, if not have already started to take off south. The juveniles tend to stick around for a lot longer, sometimes pretty close to ice up before they take off. So it looks like we do have a loon on this lake. So hopefully you enjoyed that as much as I did. I will do my best to try to catch them again. They're moving the wrong direction for, so hopefully you can make that out, but fall colors are just starting. It is the first week in September. So the east side of this lake has two bays, one to the north, one to the south, and the one we're in now is the one to the south. This little narrow is in front of us here. To the left is an island, and to the right is the mainland. And we're headed fairly close to straight south, maybe a little southeast. So it's getting quite shallow in this narrows. We might have a foot or so underneath us. So it appears that we got two islands here. Kind of a skinny narrow one, and then a little bit more of a round one. This is a cool little spot, little passage in between here. Let's go explore this. Maybe we'll come through it again and then check out the other side of the bigger island over here. Couldn't get my camera on them quick enough, but there was a couple of bluegill that just swam underneath me. So it is after July 15th, so if we wanted to, we could jump up on one of these islands and take a look, and maybe we will. We'll see. Right now, at least on this little thin island, I can see everything, so I don't see any real reason to jump up and go out there. I think what we're going to do is go right back through that narrows and then go around the other side of the bigger island. Let's get turned around here. Bunch of hemlocks back here in this corner, and there's the breeze is coming off the land, and there's just that earthy hemlock smell. Very nice. So we'll see if we can get around the south side of this bigger island. It looks a little tight, so I'm not 100% sure there's enough depth or it hasn't grown in too much. Looks a little choked, but we'll, if we can manage to get through here, we will. Little tight, but we made it. You know, I don't think we I think the camera was down a little too low. A bald eagle just jumped out from this tree right here. I didn't even notice it up there. Let's see if we can capture it around the corner here. So we've been paddling along the south side of the lake, and we're about to come into, I believe, the bay on the southeast corner here. Try to get a good view of the landing here, but this is really shallow. So we're moving out of the bay that the portage is in. It looks like there's another little bay just to the north of it. Keep hearing the loons. I'm looking for the eagle again. I don't see him. Like I said, this lake isn't super big, so we're getting around it pretty quick. Kind of head back over to the, I guess this would be the east-northeast corner. Shoreline's pretty cool. There's a bunch of cedars in here. It's like some hemlock and some white pine. Hey, thanks for watching the video this far. And if you're liking it, please give us a thumbs up down below. And if you want to see more of my content, please go down there and hit the subscribe button. We'd thank you a lot. So as you can see, we've made it back to the landing. Thanks again for coming on another Hemlocks and Loons adventure. If you got any comments or suggestions or ways we can improve the channel, please leave those down in the comments. Until next time. And I'm not sure if you just saw that owl.